Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Mike the Muppet Modeler here, and before we get going, as always, I would like to say a massive thank you to all my subscribers, new ones, existing ones, old ones. You're all amazing. Thank you very much. I couldn't appreciate it any more than I do. It's you guys that actually keep the channel going, so thank you very much. And before we get going, as you can see, we have the P-47 Thunderbolt trumpeter kit on the bench. This is the new build, this is a new start. I did do a few videos ago, the cockpit seat. Just added a little bit of grey and some mask all to that. Did the instrument panel, which has turned out quite well, I hope. Anyway, silvered the foot pedals, ready, and made up a couple of parts for the the targeting system, the HUD, the heads up display. That's what I was looking to say. So what we're going to do in this bit, all these parts now need to be sprayed, airbrushed with silver, so that's going to be the next thing. And there's also a few pieces on the sprues that need doing as well, so that's what this video is going to be all about. For starters, and then we will get into the cockpit interior colour. How am I going to do this? Just hold it, I guess. Apologies for the banging you can hear. It's someone outside my back garden. Have no idea what they're doing. We do have some new people moving in behind, so maybe it's those, I don't know. Let's get the airbrush going. I'm going to be using the silver as sort of like a base coat primer, X11 chrome silver. I've given it a good shake, so hopefully I'll do a good job. To be working fine. I'd like to say thank you very much to anyone who may have seen Bromsey Model Club at Telford, and maybe taken photos or video or whatever of the table and its contents. It was a really good display, a good mix of bits and pieces. Gunk on the end of the needle. Those two, what I think are ejector pin marks. Back parts for the seats, undercarriage leg supports, legs themselves. Obviously, you have to make sure you get all sides. That's all good. I am pleased with that, how that's turned out. That's good. So I'm going to get that back in the pot. So I will pause the video just there while I clean out the airbrush. It's gone a bit misty again, so I'll come back again in a bit when it's cleared. Right then, guys, I think a lot of the misty bit is cleared now, so what I thought I might do is make a start on the engine section. Because obviously the cockpit interior's been sprayed silver, and then it needs some maskol interior green, then a bit of extra weathering and photo etch bits to be added. The undercarriage has been sprayed, so the next bit. So we need sprues R, S and T. Right, so I think I've got all the ones I need, the sprues I need. Still a little bit in there, so I think what I might do is see if I've got a fresh one. Crack that open. Waste not, want not. Well, that's going to make it a little bit cloudy, but haven't got money to throw around, so there we go. Right, so this is sprue S, I believe. Yes, it is. And off here we want number 1 and number 7. S's, no. Seems like the rain's starting again. Good, this latest storm. Right, T6. T7, T8, T9. Look, mum, I'm counting. And 10. And if this is sprue R. Now sprue R, if I remember rightly, was a sprue I used just now. Oh, this is sprue R. So we want number 3. Mm-hmm. So two. One. Two R3s. Two R8s. R9. That's it for now. Apart from seven and four. S7, S1, and I missed S6, which is these two bits. There. Start by just cleaning up the sprue attachment points. Some really nice rivety detail around the base of that, or bolt detail. Hopefully now looking forward to my next outing, which hopefully will be Bovington Tank Museum in, I think it's normally February. I can start saving up, ready to spend some more money on kits or bits and pieces. Was really good, nice and easy. Bit of bird plastic there. It needs to come off. So we take that off. So that's good. Then we have this piece here. Goes on there like so. Helps actually if you get it round the right way. Seems like there's only one way it can go round, and I had it the right way in the first place. Caught it. So that goes there like that. That's right. And this piece goes on there, like so. Amazing how things work when you actually get it right, isn't it? Very happy with that. And then we have this piece. There's a little bit of clean up to do around there. Otherwise, I have a feeling it's not going to fit. I have one of these bits that go there. Right on the back. So, and then we have two of these round bits. And there you go, in there, like so. On that side. I've got, I don't need to give the bottle a shake at the moment. That part that goes on the top like that. Put that to one side. That piece. Like so. And that was the last one that I did. So that's that. So now I am going to put together S4 and R6. S9 and R1. So, this is the S Spirit. So, S4, which is this one here. S4. This is S9. Then we have R6. There's some really nice ejector pins on the inside of here. Some quite long, so need to just cut them down, because obviously they'll be inside so you won't see them. Hinder the sealing of the two parts. So you just need to take the tops off. Alright guys, just had to look at my watch just to make sure of the time. Don't want to be in trouble for missing the school run at all. If you can see that, how the ejector pin marks are stuck up. Might be able to cut these ones out. Always clean up. Part of the fun of modelling. watched a review today on YouTube this morning of from somebody who basically never watched Band of Brothers. And it was part 7, I believe. And, well, it just reminded me how good it is. As a series. I loved it when I watched it. I really did. I think I even have the box set upstairs somewhere. Right. Let us attach this thing. Now, I wouldn't have thought I would have had to do that. A bulldog clip might work a bit better. There's just two locator pins inside, and they're both near the top or bottom, whichever way you look at it, I guess. So it's strange. And this is exactly the same. Well, this one's got three. Excuse me. now I'm just taking off a little bit of a burr that's on it. And there are some holes to clean out here as well. We'll leave that to set down. Then we can, when we come into the next part, we can get to painting again. Nice black primer coat. For everything, then the interior green we can get going on. So all good. So I'll keep this one shortish. Seen a bit of build, bit of airbrush, so we will knock it on the head for there, and I will see you guys later in the next video. So have a good day, enjoy your evening, and I shall see you in the next one. Bye for now.